Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. So in this video, what I'm going to be doing is talking about the Evernote plans and specifically which plan is most suitable for you right now. Now, I will be doing an Evernote alternatives videos in case people are really worried about Evernote's future and are looking to transfer their experience over. And maybe in 2 weeks or so, I will be doing a video about the best method of transferring all of your notes out of Evernote. And that's just purely for security. I will be also doing how I use Evernote currently and what plan I will be going on, and I'll give you some of my personal recommendations at the end of this video. So let's dive into the plans and let's talk about which one's most suitable for you. Let's start with the Evernote Basic account, and this is free. Obviously, all you need for this one is to create an Evernote account, and it's really simple. The premise of this allows you to create notes, notebooks, and tags, and do all of the majority of stuff you would inside of the notes. So for example, use tables, attachments, collect web clippings, screenshots, audio recordings, and use some of the rich text formats like the likes of to-do lists and other such experiences. Now you can, and of course, highlight, annotate, and comment on images, attach PDFs, receipts, files, and documents, as well as search, find, and access all of your notes at speed. You can also sort and organize the information by date, title, or tag, as well as search text inside images, which is available in the free account. Now, you can share with one person or more, as well as set permissions for editing notes and notebooks. And you're probably wondering, okay, what's the important information I need to know about the Evernote free account? And that's really simple. So 60 megabytes upload limit, that's per month. So that only gives you that limit. 25 megabytes of maximum note storage. And also this plan limits you to 2 devices on this account and only recently has been updated to allowing you to use a desktop one only offline access, which I guess is pretty impressive. Now that is a free account. There is 2 other plans, Evernote Premium and Evernote Business. Of course, Evernote Business is more of the one that's used for enterprise customers. So let's talk about the Premium account. Now the Premium account is currently priced at $7.99 per user per month. And of course, there is currently a discount on Evernote Premium that some of you may be seeing, which is for 40% off. And that's for the annual pricing. So you can obviously get a huge discount there. Again, it's whether you use it, whether you sort of understand it, and that's what we'll be talking about in a moment. So the Evernote Premium obviously includes the majority of the basic, well, actually everything in the basic plan, giving you access obviously to create notes and things like that. And the sort of bonus features that you get with Premium are forwarding emails, scanning and digitizing business cards, annotating PDFs, and being able to search text inside of PDFs and office documents and images. You can see version history and turn on presentation mode. And of course, they're the core features that separate it from the likes of Evernote Basic. Now, in terms of the details, you obviously get 10 gigabytes a month, which is a massive difference from 60 megabytes a month, monthly upload limit. You can add up to 200 megabytes maximum note size, and you can have unlimited devices. Now, obviously, aside from that, you can have mobile offline access as well as a desktop access, as well as email and live access support. So again, you're getting a bit more than that. So let's talk about the which one's suitable for you. So I want to give you an example of my own experience. I mainly use Evernote to capture receipts, information, sort of, I guess, static information that I will come back to at any given time. Not necessarily on sort of a regular basis using it for meeting notes, although I previously used it for meeting notes. I don't use it for ideas. It is really just for clipping receipts, PDFs, and organizing valuable information. So again, I'm not adding a huge amount there, but again, enough to, I'm gonna be warranting myself to use Evernote free. Now, the reason I would use Evernote free and why I'm gonna move back to it from October 6th is because it has a 60 megabyte upload limit. So check on my end, I don't actually use that amount per month. I was always massively under on the 10 gigabytes. I mean, massively, like, you can actually check how many megabytes you're using a month or gigabytes. And I was always like 99% actually not used. 25 maximum note size, 25 megabytes. Again, for me using and uploading PDFs, unless they're massive, I'm not gonna have that there. two devices. I would uninstall it from Android and any other device I've got, but of course I could use it on web. So if I ever needed to use it on another computer, I could use the web version. So my Mac and my iOS phone would work great. And of course, desktop offline access would really help. And of course, that's part of the free plan. So for me, the Evernote free plan actually works quite well. I'm not ditching Evernote because I actually have 6 years worth of really valuable information there. It's actually quite useful. But again, I'll talk more about that in my own setup video. Now, Evernote, of course, for you, you might be looking at that going, okay, you know, am I using it enough? And this might be the sort of bugaboo for you. So for example, if you heavily use forward emails, that's obviously going to be something that you're going to need in premium. If you're desperately need like the card scanning function, you scan a lot of business cards in, you connect them with your contacts in LinkedIn, then that obviously is going to be a premium feature. Annotating PDFs, I know a lot of people do that, but again, there are alternative applications that allow you to do that. Obviously, some people like that all inside of Evernote, but again, there are alternatives. And some people do like the ability to search for text inside of PDFs, office documents, and images. So that's inside of Premium too. Now, of course, you can see the version history of your notes and presentation mode. So if you're a heavy user of that, that's going to obviously get you there. Now, one of the things that I would say is if you're uploading more than, obviously more than 60 megabytes per month, then Premium warrants you. If you are looking at like about 100 megabytes a month or maybe 200 megabytes a month, you can discuss with yourself, okay, do I need the Premium version just for the sake of, an extra 100 megabytes, or can I crunch everything down to 60 megabytes a month and sort of stick with that? And you've got to ask yourself as well, do you use more than 25 megabytes per note file size? So for example, if you are uploading things like, MP4 files or MP3 files, then that's really going to get you, like it's going to be a big upload, necessarily a big one. And if you use it on a lot of devices as well, if you have three or four more devices that use it, the Premium is definitely your best bet. And if you're a big mobile access user, so for example, you know you travel a lot and you need them offline, then that's obviously going to be your sort of go-to bet. So my recommendations are really, if you are an Evernote free, if you're an Evernote Premium customer and you don't necessarily use the forwarding email and some of the Premium functions, and you can warrant the downgrade, for example, you can say to yourself, okay, actually, I don't use that monthly upload that much. My maximum note size is small. I don't use it on that many devices, or I could drop the amount of devices I've got and I would only need it desktop only access. Then you might be more warranting moving up down to Evernote free. Now, what I'm gonna say is that if you do need it, if you are a heavy user of Evernote, carry on with Evernote Premium or Evernote Business, whatever's suitable for you, because it will benefit you. And of course, if you're happy with that, but if you're on that borderline, I'm gonna be moving down to Evernote free on the 6th of October, I believe it is, once my Premium runs out. And that's actually the first time I'm going free in 5 years, which is crazy. And then, for example, if they add stuff to it, or they, if they add stuff to it, or it becomes more valuable, or I work out that I'm using more monthly upload, then I probably will move back. So guys, hopefully that gave you some useful insights into the Evernote sort of pricing plans. Let me know in the comments what your store structure will be. Again, I didn't necessarily touch on the business account. The business account is $14.99 per month. You can read about all the pricing plans below. But again, I think this was more of a, should I go for Evernote free or Evernote premium? Anyway, guys, I really appreciate you stopping by today. I really hope you enjoyed this feature. Let me know in the comments below what you think about the Evernote subscription pricing, whether it's good price or bad price. Let me know. I'd really love to hear, because obviously they're making a lot of changes and developments in this area. Anyway, guys, make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.